Hi, YouTubers. I'm glad you're all here. Thank you very much for joining me. Don't forget to please subscribe and please share my videos. Last night near Huntersville, West Virginia, there was a magnitude 2.5 earthquake. I have three monitors that I downloaded. And going to Google Earth, here's the location of that 2.5. USGS downgraded it to a 2.0. Up over here, we have Huntersville. I imagine some people probably did feel it and didn't bother reporting it to USGS. All right, I'm going to show you the monitors that I'm using. There's one real close, right up over here, right there. Now, that is R55A, which would be this first monitor on the left. And we'll go to the spectrogram. It shows up on all three monitors that I downloaded. There you go. And I will enlarge the monitor that it actually showed up on, or the closest monitor. And we'll bring it down so you can see the size of this earthquake. Down there at the bottom, it says MD 2.51. That would be the Marlington, West Virginia monitor. I also have it for Dark Hollow, Roseland, Virginia. And then the one at the bottom, Dingies, Beckley, West Virginia. That's a coal mining area. You know, I was thinking about the coal miners and all the earthquakes. Boy, I wouldn't want to be down there in a large earthquake. We really got to give a shout out to the coal miners. Yeah, it's a tough life. Going back to Google Earth, here's that first monitor right there. This one here is for Beckley. Yeah, it's a coal mining town right there. Your electric cars would not be able to be charged if it wasn't for the coal miners or the oil and gas industry. Yeah, where do you think it's coming from? Certainly not from so much for wind and solar. The other monitor I am using is this one over here. It's listed as Dark Hollow, or Hollow, Roseland, West Virginia. This 2.5 USGS is reporting is the only earthquake in this location for the last week, and also for the last month. But you guys that live there know hogwash. Yeah, there's been other earthquakes. All right, let's close this out. You'll see we got one marked in red here. Let me pull it up a little bit. And we got another one marked in red right there. And let's go to its seismic signature for those two. There's the one. Now these two also would have been last night. Let me bring this up. And then we got one, oh, not too long ago when I was pulling the data. Right there, 1449. Now that is universal time. That would have been at 10:49 a.m. local time. Let's take a look at the spectrogram. Yeah, deep one. Now, looking at the spectrogram for the 2.5, this was 8 miles below sea level. And let's go back down to this other one that occurred at 10:49 a.m. Yeah, it was probably even deeper. Probably 10 miles below sea level, or maybe a little bit more. This one comes in as a magnitude 1.96. And we'll go to its seismic signature. Interesting. Now, these are all what's considered interplate earthquakes. Slightly rounded tops. Yeah, you guys, well, you got a coal mine there. Any ancient volcanoes in that location? Let's take a look at this one. You interplate earthquakes that really don't know how or why. Well, common sense will tell you because of the Atlantic plate pushing, going west, pushing against the North American plate. It's why you got the Appalachian Mountains. And this area, yeah, look at that. Yeah, well, it's deep. See, that's harmonic tremors. Yeah, it's deep. It's down there where the collision is happening, and yeah, subduction is happening. So that's probably what it's picking up. Yeah, the melted subduction of the Atlantic plate going underneath the North American plate. Drawn out in green is the Southern Appalachian seismic zone, and you probably can see the mountains through here. Yeah, there's some areas that are really steep when I was looking around at different locations, zooming in. Now, this 2.6, that was last year, January 16th, and this is last night's 2.5. Going towards the east, let's pull this out. We got the Chesapeake Bay. You might find this interesting. About 35.5 million years ago, an exploding meteor collided with the Earth and formed a massive crater because rivers flow along the path of least resistance. The depression created a crater, causing river valleys to converge, setting the stage for the formation of the Chesapeake Bay. On Wikipedia, they have an image showing the impact area. The inner rim, it shows here. And then going to Google Earth, this would be the impact area. Let's come out a little bit more. Yeah, I bet you guys, a lot of you guys didn't know that this is a location of an ancient, impact crater. Well, if you look at it, can you see that? A little bit discoloration in this area. Isn't geology amazing? I wonder how many walking along the river edges or the bay edges found rocks that look like this and didn't even realize they were what's called shatter cones. That's from the impact of the meteor. You can do a Google search for Chesapeake Bay shatter cones. There's one. There's another. I bought one on eBay. Yeah, pretty amazing. All right, let's go over and look at some more. Here we got another one. I don't know if all these are from the Chesapeake Bay. It says the crater is about 35 miles in diameter and about 1.3 kilometers deep. Not even quite a mile deep, twice the size of Rhode Island. It doesn't sound very deep, but it's nearly as deep as the Grand Canyon. Thinking about the Tonga volcano and the ash that went in up into our stratosphere and how it's affecting the weather. Well, this probably did that too. Shattered rock were cast high into the atmosphere for hundreds of miles along the east coast. A enormous mega tsunami engulfed the land and possibly even reached the Blue Ridge Mountains. What movie was it where the kid discovered the asteroid that was going to impact the Earth? And at the end of the movie, he took his girlfriend and the girlfriend took their parents' baby on the motorcycle and were trying to get up high into the mountains. You guys would probably remember the name of that movie, but it reminds me of that. It looks like that impact crater was not discovered until 1983. That's probably why many people don't even know about it. Yeah, I'm going to have to draw that out here on Google Earth. Let's bring this out and go back to that earthquake that was recent. Yeah, I'm sure that created a lot of ancient faults and cracks in the earth when that impacted. But if you did feel this earthquake, this magnitude 2.5, that USGS has a 2.0, there in Huntersville, put that information down below. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you for subscribing. Thank you for sharing my videos. Thank you very much for your support. If you wish to support my work, I'm also on Patreon. You can join for as little as $1 a month. Thank you again. Please stay safe, and I will talk to you later. God bless y'all.